Good morning, North Brantford, and welcome to the Spring 2022 Thunder Center. I'm Sam.
And I'm Carly. Let's get right into it.
Wind, rain, or shine, the Ultimate Frisbee team was hard at work on the field this season. Here's Nate with some inside flicks of the team.
The Frisbee team wasted no time getting into the action this season. Let's take a look.
Ultimate Frisbee is one of the most novel sports we have here at MBHS. Our team had an interesting and extremely successful season. The team had a win-loss record of 5-5 in their division, and they ended the season second in the state after going to championships on Saturday, May 21st. The team also had a very successful senior night, winning the game 15-4 against Coventry. The alumni game on May 23rd was a lot of fun for everyone involved. They had a huge turnout with a lot of alumni returning to play. Our current team, however, confidently won the game.
Hey guys, welcome back to Daily Aiden Chittenden Vlogs. Today we are beating the alumni at their own game.
Well, we're kind of crushing them. What's the score?
The team has a lot of fun together on and off the field. Here is Ashton, a senior, on the atmosphere of the team.
The team atmosphere is really positive. You know, everyone really has fun and enjoys each other. And we all like to like go out after practice or games sometimes and just have a lot of fun.
Grant, a junior on the team, tells us what the team does together after a game.
Well, actually, typically we go out to eat. We go to a different restaurant after each game and we just have a meal together as a team.
Coach Filippides shared both his hope for next year's team and a desperate plea.
I'm excited for Aiden Hutchinson. That guy knows how to throw a flick and a backhand. Also, I'm excited for Aiden Chittenden. He can jump over everybody, and that's including sometimes, but not always, Jaden Sorrell. That guy makes every team worried. Besides that, I'm also excited for every other person that will be joining the Frisbee team next year to get on our lineup. Everyone's welcome for the Frisbee team. We have a lot of fun and we make some great plays. So if you want to join the Frisbee team next year.
What an amazing season. Congrats to everyone on the team. For the T-Bird News, I'm Nate Higgins.
Running never stops here at North Brantford, and the outdoor track team is leading by example. Sam was running right alongside them.
This year, track was back in action. Let's lace up our shoes and check it out.
This year, the outdoor track team was back competing in their meets versus HK, Cog, Morgan, and many more. Their captains this year were Regan Lee, Sophie Gambardella, and Ryan Chesnoff.
I was able to talk to Captain Sophie Gambardella about her goals for next year.
So the goals and plans for next season, I'm really hoping that we get to do more fundraisers because we started doing a lot of them this year, and just more involvement and team bonding experiences. And our team did really good this year, and a lot of us had qualified for Shorelines. One of our teammates, Sam Gott, did qualify for states, so I'm hoping that next year maybe like more members might be able to, and even like Shorelines is great too.
The track team made a lot of great memories and was able to have a great season as well. For T-Bird News, I'm Sam.
Jared's gym class isn't the only group out on the tennis courts. The North Brantford tennis team is the real deal, and Sam caused quite the racket capturing the action.
This year, the tennis team was ready to hit the courts. I was able to get a closer look.
This year, the tennis team improved a lot with their record being 5-13, facing a lot of good teams in their matches. They played teams such as Old Lyme and East Hampton. This year, the girls were very flexible with adjusting between playing singles and doubles. One strong player was Captain Drewby Patel, who was their number one single, and Peyton Kaminsky, who was their number two single.
I was able to talk to Captain Dia Patel about her advice for next year.
One piece of advice that I would give to players for next year is start hitting earlier, start hitting over the summer, go to clinics, hit with experienced players for all the new players, and just have fun and try to like work harder and condition more so we could like win a few more games next year.
Looks like the tennis team had a fabulous season this year. For T-Bird News, I'm Sam.
A missed shot is few and far between with our golf team. Here's Carly shouting for the team.
The golf team has been chipping, putting, and driving their way through an excellent season. I was able to get a closer shot.
The golf team has made great strides in their 2022 season. The team practices at Indian Springs Golf Course in Middlefield, Connecticut, where they practice swinging, putting, and all around refining their skills. They were able to beat Morgan High School, who was their biggest competition, and scored a 164 in a match against Maloney High School, making that their best score of the season. I talked to captains Blake Pearson and Dakota Cooper to hear more.
I'd have to say my favorite memory from this year is our van rides on the way home from when we win, because Rob's giggle is just a thing of beauty, I'll tell you.
So our goals at the beginning of the season were to make shorelines and qualify for states. We made shorelines, we finished third. That was better than our goal. We did better than last year. Our goal for states is to finish in the top 10.
Their hard work led them to enter the Shoreline Tournament in second place and coming out in fourth out of 11 teams.
It looks like the golf season was all around up to par. For T-Bird News, I'm Carly Parenti.
The boys lacrosse team once again fed off each other's energy and accomplished a lot this year. Nate was on the sidelines for this one.
Our boys lacrosse team worked very hard this season. Let me show you how they did.
Boys lacrosse started the season off winning many games with big leads. They won 13-6 against Old Saybrook, 13-2 against Cromwell, and 14-5 against Old Lyme, all right here on our field. The team then also took some tough, close losses against Morgan, Valley, and Brantford. Our T-Birds went into overtime against HK, sadly losing 5-6. Our boys lacrosse team did come back to beat Morgan 12-10 later in the season, though. The team did not take its losses lightly and focused on growing as a team.
We were closer this year because we were able to do more stuff with less COVID restrictions. Like, we had the locker room this year. Like, we didn't have the locker room last year, and we did a bunch of pasta dinners, so we were able to bond as a team more than we really did last year.
The team grew a lot closer this season. Besides team bonding, many players on the team have improved a lot since the start of the season.
We had a lot of underclassmen show up for us. They stepped in for us in games when we needed roster spots to be filled, so we had a lot of underclassmen step up to that role. Some juniors changing around their positions to better affect the team overall.
Our T-Birds are excited for next year's season.
Next year, I'm looking forward to winning the Shoreline Championship, making a deep run in states. We have a really strong junior class. It's going to be a bunch of seniors next year, so we have a really good shot at the playoffs.
Although the team was disappointed by their record this season, they still made time to grow. For the T-Bird News, I'm Nate Higgins.
To keep the lacrosse train going, the girls' lacrosse team had as spectacular a season as ever. Carly was able to watch them in the action.
The girls' lacrosse team has been moving up the bracket in a very successful season this year. I was down on the field to see the action.
The girls' lacrosse team started their season off strong and have kept the trend going throughout the season. They've taken home a number of big wins, such as Cromwell 21-11, Old Lyme 22-12, and in one of their biggest games, they were able to beat an undefeated Valley 20-13. Our team is currently the third seed in the Shoreline Tournament, facing off against teams such as Old Saybrook and Valley, which will be our biggest competition. Returning coach Miss Connolly was able to give me more information.
Our girls lacrosse season has been spectacular so far. We finished our regular season 12-4, which is a very good record for us. We made it to the Shoreline Tournament. Unfortunately, we lost in the finals, which was upsetting, but we get a chance to rematch against Old Saybrook on Friday, where we've advanced to the quarterfinals for the state tournament. So I'm really excited. I think we have a chance to make it all the way this year, and I just want the girls to keep working hard and fighting hard like they've been doing all season.
The team has been no stranger to injuries this season, but with a team full of experienced players, they were able to pull through together and were tournament ready. I talked to the captains to hear their take on the season.
Going into the season, our goals were just to have a winning season and then make it far in the Shoreline and State Tournament. We graduated a lot of our starting lineup, especially our defense and goalie last year, so we were just looking to have a good season and work hard as a team to get far in the tournaments.
My favorite part of this year's lacrosse season was definitely beating Valley because they were undefeated.
My favorite memory of the season was before a North Haven game, all of us just hanging out in the parking lot and blasting music out of Sam's car and getting hyped before the game. It was just a really fun team memory.
The advice that I have for the underclassmen would have to be to play every game like it's your last, because you never know when you could be playing your last high school game, and to take the field every time, determined, motivated, wanting to do well, work hard, play as a team, and most of all, just have fun.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
It looks like the lacrosse team is finishing their season as strong as they started. For T-Bird News, I'm Carly Parenti.
Hey Sam, I've got a joke for you. What did the baseball glove say to the ball?
I don't know.
Catch you later.
Good one, Car. The baseball team knows what we're talking about. Paul Vaffone was at the plate to check them out.
The softball team finally caught their stride after a little bit. Let me show you.
With a regular season record of 12 wins to 8 losses, the baseball season had its up and downs, but it overall had a pretty good turnout. The T-Birds advanced to the semifinals of the Shoreline Tournament, but lost to Valley Regional. Here are the captains to tell us how they think the season went.
We started off a little slow, but we started to pick it up. We went on a hot streak, and let's just keep it rolling through states.
The season's been going very well. Team's gotten together a lot behind the scenes, on and off the field, mostly off the field, obviously. The bonding has been very good. It helps us on the field with everything, picking up teammates and just like the little stuff. The biggest thing we expressed in the beginning of the season is having good team chemistry, and that's probably something we exceeded on, something very well this season.
So the Thunderbird baseball team, we've had a really good year. We started out with some struggles early on. We had a couple injuries, then we got hit with some sickness. We started the season only 4-6. And at that point in time, you find out a lot about a team. Either a team's going to fight and they're going to figure it out, or they're going to pack it in. Well, we learned so much about the character of our team. We turned it around. We finished the regular season at 13-7. We were able to secure a home playoff game for the first round of the states. We made it to the semifinals of Shorelines. And now we're moving on to the quarterfinals and states. We're just trying to take it one game at a time. That's what these kids have done such a great job this year. As a team, it's always one game at a time. Just try to get a little bit better every single day. And we'll see where it goes. Hopefully the next step's the semifinals.
Good luck to the softball team in states. For T-Bird News, I'm Paul Raffone.
Hey Carly, you're not the only one with bad jokes.
Oh really? Let's hear it then.
Which softball player holds the water?
I don't know, Sam.
A pitcher.
Speaking of pitching, the softball team has hit their stride late in the season to return to their postseason form. Paul got a closer look.
The softball team finally caught their stride after a little bit. Let me show you.
The girls held their heads up strong with a regular season record of 13-7. They did so great with star athletes like Kylie Mullins and Lindsay Onofrio. Lexi Falcioni is a prominent up-and-coming player. I spoke with seniors Lauren Ackerman, Bella Hills, Hannah Cernersha, Gianna DiPino, and Nicole Gomez, as well as Coach DeLizio, on how their season went.
My most memorable moment from the season was definitely winning the Shoreline Conference Championship for the 7th year in a row, and also just the team chemistry that we have on and off the field.
In my career of North Brantford softball, my most memorable moment was making it to states last year. The beginning of the season, we started off with a rough start, being 0-3, but as the season continued, we really pulled it together and we ended up winning Shorelines again, so yeah.
In the beginning of the season, we did not have a very good bond because all the new girls coming up and like it was new environment for everyone. But then throughout the season, we started getting closer and we worked all together, and that's how we won all the games from now on.
The goals for the rest of the season are to keep playing our best and hopefully make it to the state championship and win it all this year. For next season, I think the girls just want to play well together and kind of glue together like we did this year and keep making runs in the Shoreline and state tournaments.
Team has been doing very well as of late. We started off a little slow,
You know, we played three really good programs right in the beginning of the season to start it off. You know, there was probably a lot of pressure on us too in the beginning of the season, coming off of last year's successes. So this year we had a lot of growing pains to start with, but I knew things were going to come through in the end. Leadership definitely stepped up with the five seniors that we have coming into our own. We got hot at the right time. Towards the end, we played some tough teams like East Haven and Cromwell to set us up for the Shoreline Tournament. And we really played three championship games in a row, from Coginchog HK to Old Lyme in the finals. And, you know, we're looking for that success throughout the state tournament as well. We got by the first two rounds, and hopefully today we can be successful against Chippewa Valley and move on and continue our success. So, because sky's the limit for this team. If they want it, they can have it. They just got to work hard. We play our best. We've had great attitudes and the will to win and the will to succeed. So I'm very proud of them, and let's see where we can go with this.
Good luck to the softball team in states. For T-Bird News, I'm Paul Raffone.
That's a wrap for this year's Spring Thunder Center. Best of luck in states to all who qualify. For the last time, I'm Sam.
And I'm Carly, signing off. Roll Birds!